Okay, a glass of water. Ah, water. From the feeding bottle time of mine, I have been consuming water. My mom gave me as an infant, and I gave my daughter, and she gives to her daughter. Okay, sounds like Woodward's grape water advertisements. As I grew, I came to know more about you, more the inputs I mean, information about you, more I became puzzled, and not a day has gone without thinking about it. So today, I have decided to have a conversation with you. Yes, directly let you know that I know too little about you, and it's not only you that I don't fully know. Same is with the light, fire, air and colors. Okay, in short, nature. Why do I say that? Look, when I was taught direct linear motion of light, it was so straightforward. The light has a particle. But diffraction bent the light as a wave and made me recall that day. Every time when I see the moon, its umbra and penumbra, they are because of the diffraction. Right? So, be it that. So, the duality, the particle and the wave duality, interested me to stick on to basic physics. That took me inward to quantum physics. Now, what about you? The water. First, I will tell you a bit of what I know, without giving the statistical numbers like 30% of fresh water is in the ground, 68%, 4% is in glaciers. To get 500 sheets of paper, you require 1300 and gallons of water. Or a very simple fact that 70% of my brain is all water. But then, I have been noticing one more thing, like hot water, lukewarm water, chilled water, normal water, all taste slightly different, very subtle change. The tender coconut water, when I drink directly from the coconut, or use the straw and drink, or pour it in a glass and drink, they all taste different, very subtly though. So, what do I know about you? Apart from, fine, these are the points that I know about you. You are odorless, you are tasteless, you are colorless. And with a boiling point of 100 degrees Celsius and a melting point of 0 degrees Celsius. And you can dissolve more than any other fluid, you can dissolve many matters. And compared to any other liquid, like even sulfuric acid. Even beyond that, you know, you can, the number of matter that you can dissolve is much more than even a sulfuric acid. So, and then you are existing in all the three states, solid, liquid and gaseous. Surprisingly, you don't add to my calories when I drink you, and you don't have any nutrients, but you are so essential for all the living organisms. Okay, when you are a solid, you don't go inside like any other solid matter. So, that is when we were asked to accept something known as anomalous expansion of water. So, what is anomalous? Something peculiar like, you know, your solid state is behaving in a different way. Okay, so that anomalous expansion of water. So I imagined what will happen if only, you know, like any other solid matter, you go inside. So you would have become ice, 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 everything. So it will be fully ice. So what will happen to all the living organisms which are there under the ocean? They would have been dead and gone by now. So I accept that you are so wonderful. And you are so compassionate. also from all lakes and rivers and oceans, you get evaporated. Transport yourself so beautifully, so elegantly, and so swiftly, and make potable water available for those inlanders. You regulate the Earth's temperature. So what are you made up of to have such beautiful qualities in you? Fine, for centuries you are considered as an element, a chemical substance, an element, which in 17th century Cavendish proclaimed it as a compound of hydrogen and oxygen, which are covalent. Covalent means no sharing of electrons, so the loose electrons. So, two covalent bonds of sharing, two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. Okay, because sharing for what? Sharing for the stability of both sides. But as we went deeper into the atom and knew about the subatomic particles and quarks, apart from the electrons, protons and neutrons, all orbiting around. Okay. So, now what are you made up of? 19th century scientific world came to realize more of the mysteries of mysterious way you are behaving when you are supposed to cross a potential barrier. So when a potential barrier is changing shape, you are behaving differently. So that is quite mysterious. You are not the same. Now, hydrogen bonding and clustering of water. Now, we think that you are as a compound H2 and O. 2H2 plus O. 2O will give you 2H2O. Now, the hydrogen bonding and the clustering of a water molecule resonate in the ears of the scientific world. So, more I went deeper within you and was getting lost when I very appropriately hear my mom reciting something on Lord Ganesha. Just to check her memory, she was trying to recite it. My ears captured only these two lines. Anuvit kanuvai, appal kappalai, kanumuchu nindra, karumbulle kaati. So, go deeper and deeper, and I am getting lost with you. So, oh water, I will ask one of my neighbors, Dr. R. Amudan, who is still into that and who is talking about the clustering and the photons and all that. So I will ask him to explain me what exactly is going on in the scientific world about you. Okay, so this is only a part of the conversation with water. I'll get back to you with a revived energy, with a revived information, and definitely I know that I will be lost a little further inside.